Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I am going to show you how to save and export an Angular diagram. You will see how to save and load a diagram as a string and file stream. I will also show you how to export a diagram with different file formats. First, I open an Angular application containing a diagram component with the nodes and connectors to design a flowchart. To learn more about integrating the diagram component into an Angular application, please use the Getting Started video linked in the card above and the description below. Let me run this application using the command ng-serve. The diagram canvas renders with the specified flowchart. Next, I will show you how to save and load the diagram. A diagram can be saved using either a string or file stream. First, let's see how to save the diagram in a JSON string format and load the diagram using the same string. I am going to use the Syncfusion Angular button component to save the diagram. So, I install the Syncfusion Angular Buttons package by running the command ng-add Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Buttons. In the app module file, you can see the button module is automatically imported from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Buttons package and injected into the imports array of the ng module. I add the button component by defining the EJS button attribute with the content save. Then add the event click with the event handler on save. I define the onSave method in the app component TS file. To access the diagram's built-in method, I add a reference to the diagram component. To create the instance, I first need to import the ViewChild directive from the Angular core package. Then, using the ViewChild directive, I define the variable diagram object to create the diagram instance. I declare the variable diagram data to save the JSON string and assign the diagram as a JSON string to diagram data by calling the saveDiagram method using the diagram instance. Next, to load this saved string as a diagram, I add another button with the content load and add the click event callback method name to onLoad. Next, I define the onLoad method, where I call the loadDiagram method using the diagram instance and pass the string data stored in the diagram data variable. In the app component CSS file, I'll add the margin style for the button to align it. Here, I inspect the page and add the debugger in the onSave and onLoad methods to show the saved string. When I click the Save button, the diagram will be saved as a string to the variable diagram data. To show the load operation, I select and delete all the elements in the diagram canvas. When the Load button is clicked, the previously saved string will be updated as a diagram in the canvas. Next, I'll show you how to save and load a diagram as a file stream. First, I define the method to provide cross-browser support for downloading JSON data. Then, add an if condition to check whether the browser is Microsoft-based, and create a blob for the data parameter received. This blob is then saved using the msSave or OpenBlob method, with the file named diagram.json. For the other browsers, it creates a data URL containing the data as JSON. Then create an anchor element. Set its hypertext reference attribute to the data URL. And its download attribute to diagram.json. I append this anchor element to the document body. At last, click and remove the anchor element. I call this method inside the onSave callback method to download JSON data on the Save button click. I'll comment out the previous code for better clarity. When I click the Save button, the diagram is saved as a JSON file. Next, I will show you how to load a diagram using the file stream. To upload the JSON file from the local location, I am going to use the Syncfusion uploader component. So, I install the Syncfusion Angular uploader package by running the command ng-add Syncfusion ej2 Angular inputs. In the app module file, you can see the uploader module is automatically imported from the Syncfusion ej2 Angular inputs package and injected into the imports array of the ng module. Next, I add the ejs uploader component with basic properties. I have defined the async settings property with the proper save URL to handle save operation in the uploader. First, I comment out this loadDiagram method to load a diagram from a saved state. Next, I retrieve an uploader element with the class name eFileSelectWrap using getElementsByClassName method. If the uploader element exists, I use the querySelector method to get the button element within the uploader. Then, I use the click method of this button to initiate the file selection process. Whenever the file is successfully uploaded, the success event will be triggered. So, I'll add the success event with the callback method onUploadSuccess. I define this callback method in the app component TS file. Inside this method, I will receive the uploaded file details as arguments. I assign this file details to the variable fileData. I declare another variable file to get the raw file from the received details as a blob. Then, I initialize the file reader instance to read the file content. And call the readAsText method from the file reader and pass the raw file. I define another method, loadDiagram, which receives the progress of the file upload as an event, and where I get the file reader result and pass it to the loadDiagram method using the diagram component. Then, I bind this method to the onLoadEnd property of the file reader. In the app component CSS file, I'll hide the uploader component by setting the display style none to its wrapper element. To show the load operation, I select and delete all the elements in the diagram canvas. When I click the load button, the file selection dialog pops up, allowing me to choose a JSON file. You can see the diagram loaded using the JSON file downloaded. Next, I will show you how to export a diagram. The Syncfusion Angular diagram supports exporting to PNG, JPEG, BMP, and SVG formats. Let's start with PNG format. In the app component TS file, I import the print and export model class and diagram component from the Syncfusion ej2 Angular diagrams package. And then, I inject this model into the diagram component. Then, add one more button with the content export. And a click event with the event handler on export. I define the event handler and declare the variable export options based on the interface export options, which is imported from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Diagrams package. Then, I set the format to PNG and mode to download. I pass these export options to the export diagram method using diagram instance. When I click the export button, the diagram is exported in PNG format. Similarly, you can print the diagram using the print method. I add one more button with the content print and a click event with the event handler on print. I define the event handler here and declare the variable print options based on the interface export options. Then, I set the mode to data. I pass these print options to the print method using a diagram instance. When I click the print button, the diagram is prepared for printing and displayed as a printable document. Refer to the documentation link attached in the description for more details on exporting and printing diagrams. In this video, you have seen how to save and load the diagram component as a string and a file stream. You have also seen how to export the diagram in different file formats. You can download a working example of this from the GitHub link in the description for this video. I've also included a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.